Welcome to the Chelsea High School Year 2000 Spring Concert. It's wonderful to see you all here tonight. I hope that all of you have taken the opportunity to view the portfolio art exhibit that is displayed in the lobby, the product of many months of hard work on the part of our portfolio art students and art instructor Maren Olson and Betty Slater. Before we begin our concert, I'd like to request that there be no flash photography during the performance. It is distracting to the performers and audience alike. So I repeat, please, no flash photography. And please turn off any cell phones or pagers or set them on vibrate. I'd like to give a special thanks to the administration, Principal Mr. Lincoln Tamayo, and especially the custodians, who, because MCAT testing had to break down the stage with tables, and tomorrow we'll have to set it back up again. We very much appreciate their extra time and work. I'd like to present, I'm thrilled to be able to present to you Mr. John Nichols, our choral conductor and the choral leader, who rehearsed 5 days a week. They're accompanied by Mrs. Marilyn Glover, and they have a wonderful variety of music for you. Please give them a wonderful audience and a nice round of applause. The choral is Mrs. John Nichols.
To be joined together as one, we can build a bridge of
Part of the Chelsea High School chorus. We're going to be resetting the stage in a moment. Not only does Chelsea have many, many talented visual arts students, but we have many talented instrumentalists as well. The next two students in the program have worked very hard on their own. We're going to have Mr. John Figueroa play Moonlight Sonata by Beethoven on the piano, followed by Charlene Knopstadt on the flute, with Allegro by Jean-Baptiste Gaultier, and I'm sure I pronounced that wrong. Please give us your patience for just 1 minute while we reset the stage. Thank you.
Thank you.
As you can see, we're setting the stage for the band. It's a pity that this will probably be the last year that the band will be small enough to fit on the same stage as the Coral Risers. It's terrible when the band gets too big for the stage. Chelsea has started an instrumental program in the fifth grade. And the fifth and sixth grade students who are beginning band members are now coming up to the ranks and will be the high school band in the next 3 or 4 years. What's amazing, and what's a testimony to our band director, our high school band director, Patrick McCann's perseverance, is that we have a high school band now. And many of the students in the high school band have been taking lessons other instruments for a year, in some cases less. They rehearse twice a week after school. I even saw them the day before Thanksgiving, after school till 3:30. And it's been through a lot of hard work and dedication that we have a band of the size and caliber that we do now. If you'd like to hear a little bit more of them, some of the students will be playing in front of City Hall on Memorial Day at 10 a.m. for a ceremony there. Now, if I just have your patience for a few more minutes, the band will do its first piece.
One more second while we move on to the stage in our normal positions. just like to take a second to say thank you again to everyone who's made this program possible, and to point out briefly that to date, this is the largest band we've had, with the largest number of repertoire on any one concert. And you'll also notice that as the years have gone by, our concert pieces have gotten faster and faster. The students have been able to handle more and more difficult music with different rhythmic patterns and different styles. So this next piece is our first real march we're going to be performing here at Chelsea, and I hope you all enjoy it. Thank you.
Before we conclude with the Chelsea High School chorus, I would like to recognize by name the portfolio art students whose work is displayed outside, and reiterate again the extraordinary amount of time and effort, not to mention blood, sweat, and tears, that goes into hanging an art show. When time and effort goes into music, you see it and you hear it. When time and effort goes into an art show, a lot of it's backstage, and you see the nice picture. But I would like to publicly recognize and thank lead art teacher Betty Slater and art instructor Maren Olson for the incredible amount of work they have done with the students and hanging the art show. And I would like also to read the names of the exhibiting artists. Again, please forgive my pronunciation. And artists, if you are here, would you just please stand so that we may recognize you? These are the artists exhibited outside: Robert Canegues, Wendy Castillo, Soka Che, Edward Cintron, Max Perina, Leila Gonsalves, Katrina Hill, Betty Ann Justinian, Milorad Madrunik, Jose A. Cana, and Long Sang. Can you please give those artists and the teachers a round of applause? What you see in front of you is the largest chorus that I've conducted since being in Chelsea. This is a combination of the Choraleers and rotating chorus. And what rotating chorus was a way to enable as many students as possible to be able to take advantage of the opportunity to sing. Many of these students missed classes and then had to make up work to sing. We rehearsed only once a week for about 45 minutes. Next year, we've adjusted the schedule so we don't have to do that, and I don't have to come running over here a different period every week, which is kind of a relief, but I have to say I'm going to miss it, because not only did we have a lot of work and a lot of struggles, but we had an awful lot of fun. And this is a wonderful group of students who are going to perform for you tonight. Our first piece, we have our guest narrator, Mr. Leonard Nieman, narrating, and the soloist is Mr. Rami Medina.
All right. I am an American. Let my song be a song of freedom. Let the melody sound the call of liberty. Let the rhythm beat the drum of justice. Let the words be a testament of our gratitude that proudly declares, I am an American. Sing, America, sing.
Thank you.
When you have a large chorus and you have some time, you're able to do some of the classic choral repertoire. The Heavens Are Telling is from Haydn's big oratorio, The Creation. And our soloists are Esther and from the very highly successful musical Rent called Seasons of Love. And I'd like to take this opportunity again to thank the administration, the school committee, every visitor that's here, all the parents, and my colleagues John Nichols, Henry McCann, and most especially I would like to thank you, the students, for the privilege of working with you. Thank you very much.